It is Hollywood's highest honor, and now a few more Canadians have Oscar bragging rights. People from this country landed three of the golden statuettes this year, and one of those was for Best Production Design. Jim Erickson took the award for his work in the critically acclaimed biopic Lincoln, and he joins me on the phone from Salt Spring Island, B.C. Jim, congratulations. I've got a big grin on for you. What about you?
Oh, my grin's still kind of plastered on there, absolutely.
Now, you weren't actually at the Dolby Theater. You didn't get to do anything in person. Where were you watching the show, and then what was your reaction?
Well, I was home. I had a brush with the flu last week that kind of I ended up in the hospital for a couple of days. So I just decided to better I stay home and recover.
Okay, so you're sitting on your couch or something?
I was. My brother, I had family here and a couple of neighbors, and we made a big batch of popcorn, and we sat here and jumped up and down when I won.
No kidding. So did you give your family your acceptance speech live and in person?
Actually, I did not. But I did wear a tux.
Oh, good for you. So you weren't in your jammies watching the Oscar nominations getting over
No, I got
the
all
flu.
Dressed up with a hand-tied bow tie and everything.
That's great. Now, this is your second Oscar nomination, your first win.
Yes.
How special is it? Because, you know, that first time you might have been a little nervous. This time, too, again, I'm sure. But to actually win it, how special is it?
Well, I don't know. You never really know until you do. It just seems kind of unreal. You know, the sun comes up and I still have to go to the toilet. And so life isn't really different. But, of course, you know, when the statue arrives and the courier brings it to my door, it'll be pretty special. Absolutely.
When are you expecting to get it?
I have no idea.
Okay, so this big, heavy thing comes to your door. You're going to know what it is. Do not drop it, Eric.
Yes, and in fact, last night I got a call. You know, I live on Salt Spring Island here, and there's this one guy who does all the deliveries for, you know, for the couriers for FedEx and all that. And he called last night. He says, "Oh, I'll probably be delivering that myself," he said.
Well, you know what? Maybe it'll make its rounds, Jim, kind of like the Grey Cup is done and Canadians take over trophies like that. And maybe it'll make the rounds right all over Salt Spring Island.
Well, I hope so. Yeah, why not?
Sharing. That's what we're good at in Canada.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, working with Daniel Day-Lewis, he won for Best Actor. Knowing that your team took so many accolades and working on this film with Steven Spielberg, is that a real highlight for you?
Yeah, I mean, it's you know, when it was over, and I've been kind of thinking about the last couple of years, and I'm of an age where I can retire. So, but when it was over, I just kind of said, I don't think I can do better than this. This is some of the best work I've ever done, and this is kind of the most interesting project. And I've done a lot of really interesting things in my career.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I just don't think I can do better than this. So let's go out on a high note. So I decided to retire last year also.
That's a really tough decision to make, you know, to leave on a high note when you think, oh, my goodness, now everyone knows my name.
Well, you know, the interesting thing was is when I was nominated for There Will Be Blood 4 years ago, in my position as a set decorator, it's not like being a star or, you know, it doesn't really kind of influence my career that much because, well, for whatever reasons, I don't know what the reasons are actually. So it wasn't so much that, it's just that I just felt I'd given everything I could to this business and it's been a great, great rewarding career that I've had from it. And now it's time to kind of settle down. I have this little slice of paradise here on Salt Spring Island with a great garden and to really get into gardening and cooking and playing with my new little dog and things like that. You know, it's time for a shift, I think.
It sounds wonderful. And one of the things that will be in your view will be that Oscar. So tell me, Jim, where do you plan to put it when it arrives?
I don't know. You know, I kind of collect art and things have to find their own spot.
So you'll live with it for a while and
yeah,
maybe move it around.
Yeah, it moves around and it'll find a spot somewhere. You know, like I'm kind of a, I like to say a humble kind of guy. And all my kind of, I have a hallway of shame, which is the stairwell into the basement.
You're so Canadian.
I know.
Listen,
it could end up there.
Enjoy
it may just
it.
Be too shiny for everything else.
Right. We are very proud of you. Enjoy it and enjoy your bit of paradise.
Oh, I do. And thank you so much for your interest. I really appreciate it. And thanks, everybody out there in the East. And it's just kind of, it's a testament to the industry out here in Canada, out here in Western Canada. You know, I think we've come of age, and I hope people recognize that. And maybe the governments will help out, because a lot of people are going to be unemployed very soon.
Jim, I thank you, and you're ending on a high note. I wish you the best in retirement.
Thank you so much.
Okay, Oscar winner Jim Erickson on the phone from Salt Spring Island, B.C.